Good morning all of you. Today the session is for 8th class people and the topic presented page number G3. The topic is General Organic Chemistry. Coming to the introduction of the chapter, the element present in organic chemistry is carbon. Carbon symbol is C. Coming to the atomic number, its atomic number is 6. Coming to the position of carbon, carbon present in the 48th. Its valency is 4. Valency is 4. Moreover, here carbon is a non-metal. Carbon is a non-metal. Coming to the electronic configuration, filling of electrons into the available orbitals. Now, coming to the number of electrons available, 6. 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. In the valence shell, it may have total number of electrons 4. Hence, the valency of carbon is 4. Now, the electron may transfer from 2s orbital to 2p orbital. Electron may transfer from 2s orbital to 2p orbital by gaining some energy. Hence, the electron may exit it to 2p orbital. Now, the configuration becomes 1s2, 2s1, 2p3. The 2p3 can be written as 2px1, 2py1, 2pz1. Now, in the exit state, the total number of unpaired electrons are 4. The total number of unpaired electrons are 4. The carbon can have only one exit state, first exit state. Second exit state is not possible for the carbon atom. Coming to the electronic configuration by orbital method. In the valence shell, the orbitals available 2s as well as 2p. 2s, number of degenerate orbitals 1. 2p, number of degenerate orbitals 3. 2px, 2py, 2pz. Now, the third electron may enter into 2s1, 4th, 2px1, 2py1, 2pz. Now, coming to the shape of carbon atom, due to the tetravalency, the carbon can have the geometry tetrahedral shape with the bond angle 109 degrees, 28 minutes. What is the shape of carbon here? Tetrahedral shape. Tetrahedral shape. Coming to the next subtopic, that is bonding in organic compounds. The formation of bonds in organic compound is explained by the direction of overlapping. Now, based upon the direction of overlapping, the bonds may be classified into two types, sigma bond and pi bond. Now, the differences between sigma bond and pi bond with respect to the given properties. First one, definition. What is the definition of sigma bond? The definition of sigma bond is end on end overlapping. Coming to the pi bond definition, lateral overlapping or sidewise overlapping. Coming to the electron density is concentrated on the internuclear axis along the internuclear axis. Now, in case of pi bond, the electron density is concentrated around the internuclear axis. Now, coming to the third property, that is rotation. Rotation is possible in case of sigma bond. Free rotation is possible. But in case of pi bond, due to the lateral overlapping, there is no free rotation. Nothing but a frozen rotation. No free rotation is possible in case of pi bond. Coming to the fourth property, that is bond energy. In terms of kilojoule per mole. body energy of sigma bond is high. Pi bond will take less energy to break as compared to sigma. The number of bonds between the combining atoms, when two atoms are combining, the total number of bonds are, for sigma, number of bonds are 1, but the number of bonds with respect to pi in between the combining atoms, now either 1 pi or 2 pi bonds, either 1 pi bond or 2 pi bonds. For example, if you are taking ethyl C2H2, now the carbon and carbon may have here triple bond. Out of the triple bond, one is sigma bond and the remaining two are pi bonds. Directionally, sigma bond is directional along the coordinate axis. Nothing but the electron density may concentrate on the x axis or y or z. But in case of pi bond, it is directionless. Coming to the geometry. Geometry can be identified with the help of sigma bond. Now, geometry unable to find, can't identify with the help of pi bond. Now, dependence. Sigma bond is independent. And the pi bond always depends on sigma. Nothing but s orbital always can form sigma bond, except the s orbital, remaining orbitals can form a pi bond. Now coming to the another subtopic, that is hybridization. What is the definition of hybridization? Atomic orbitals may overlap or intermixing to form new hybrid orbitals. By decreasing energy. Nothing but hybrid orbitals are highly stable. Intermixing of atomic orbitals gives hybrid orbitals. Now, what are the types of hybridization in organic compounds? The type of hybridization may classify into sp3, sp2 and sp hybridization. Number of hybrid orbitals: 1 s orbital, 3 pi orbitals, 1 plus 3, 4. In case of sp2, 1 s orbital, 2 pi orbitals, 1 plus 2, 3. In case of sp, 1 s orbital, 1 p orbital. Hybrid orbitals are 2. Actually, degenerate orbitals of p are totally 3. px, py, pz. Now, total 3 p orbitals are participating in sp3. Therefore, number of pure orbitals are pure p orbitals are 0. Nothing but nil. But in case of sp2, 3 minus 2, 1. 3 minus 1, 2. Pure orbitals are available. Number of bonds: total available orbitals, hybrid orbitals are 4. Nothing but 4 sigma bond can form. 4 sigma bond. Now here, 3 sigma, 1 pi bond. 3 sigma, 1 pi bond. While taking an example, alkene C2H4. Now, sp hybridization, 2 sigma and 2 pi bonds. By taking the example, welding gas, that is C2H2. Now, what is the bond angle of sp3 carbon? 109 degrees, 28 meters, which is the geometry tetrahedral shape. Total number of hybrid orbitals are 4. Out of that, s orbital is 1. Nothing but number of s orbitals by total orbitals into 100 will give the percentage of s character, that is 25%. Now SP2, bona angle is 120 degrees, shape is trigonal planar, trigonal planar with the percentage of S character. Number of S orbitals 1, total number of hybrid orbitals 3, 1 by 3 into 100, 33.33%. Coming to the SP, SP hybridization with the bond angle 180 degrees. Now coming to the geometry, shape is linear. Now number of S orbitals 1, total number of hybrid orbitals 2, 1 by 2 into 100, 1 by 2 into 100, 50%. Coming to the identification of hybridization with the help of two methods. Now the method one is, based upon the number of pi bonds, we can identify the type of hybridization. Now here, if pi bonds are more, nothing but a single bond carbon sp3, carbon double bond carbon sp2, carbon triple bond carbon sp hybridization. Now coming to the hybridization of carbon, the given examples. First carbon is sp3 because of having single bond. Next, second carbon having double bond with oxygen atom. Then the type of hybridization is sp2. Now here also double bond with another carbon atom, sp2. Fourth carbon also sp2, and the terminal carbon due to the presence of single bond, its hybridization is sp3. Now sp hybridization may have alternative method, that is either one triple bond or two double bonds. For sp hybridization, either one triple bond or two double bonds, nothing but this carbon is sp hybridized. Now terminal carbons are sp2 terminal carbons are sp2 and sp2. Similarly, that example, nitrogen hybridization here sp, carbon sp, second carbon sp3 due to the presence of double bond. Now beside the carbon atom, one double bond is there, that's why its hybridization is sp2. Now this carbon also sp2, and the terminal carbon is sp3. Coming to the last example, that is the given structure may have one double bond and one triple bond and one double bond, one triple and one double. Nothing but coming to the priority order, double bond can show more priority as compared to triple bond. Therefore, the number it will give from right side. Then its hybridization is sp2, and remaining these two carbon atoms are sp and sp. Coming to the note, simple note here, the diamond and graphite are the two allotropic forms of carbon. What is the definition of allotropy? Element may exist in different forms with same physical and different chemical properties. Coming to the valency of carbon in diamond. Diamond may contain carbon with valency 4. Graphite may contain carbon with valency 3. Now that's why the hybridization of carbon in diamond is sp3. Hybridization of carbon in graphite is sp2. Then now the method 1 completed, number of pi bonds. Coming to the method 2. Method 2 is based upon electron pair. If the electron pairs are 2, then the hybridization is sp. One s orbital, one p orbital. Now, if the electron pairs are 3, the hybridization is sp2. If it is 4, sp3. If it is 5, one s orbital, 3 p orbitals. 1 plus 3, 4. but availability 5 minus 4 1 introduction of another orbital, that is d. Therefore now if the electron fields are 6 s p3 d2, the electron fields are 7 s p3 d3 sp3 d3 right. Now in this session we discussed about the introduction of organic chemistry, bonding in compounds with the differences between sigma bond and pi bond, and another subtopic is hybridization in organic compounds. Identification of hybridization by two methods. First method is number of pi bonds, and the second method is electron pairs. Okay, now continuation we will discuss in the next class. Thanks for watching.